Hello YouTube world, my name is Nicholas Montes and you're watching my YouTube channel, The Teenage Movie Critic. And welcome back to my YouTube channel, everybody. I'm so excited to have you back together again. And in today's video, we're going to be reviewing the first MCU Disney Plus series for 2023. It's actually been a while since we had a new Disney Plus MCU series since She-Hulk, which has been kind of crazy because I thought we would be getting something in like March or February or something like that. But no, I'm guessing Marvel's taking their time and they're actually putting their work into this stuff. So today we're reviewing the first episode of Secret Invasion. But before we get started talking about the first episode of Secret Invasion, let me tell you my thoughts on, like, what were my thoughts going into this show? Okay, so this is kind of a typical one. This is a difficult one to kind of talk about because there's actually a lot to talk about with this one because as a Marvel fan itself, you know, I always liked the idea of this show where Skrulls were going to invade the Earth and they're pretending to be other superheroes and stuff like that. But then I started thinking, wait a second. I saw Captain Marvel. The Skrulls were good guys. So if they're going to make a Secret Invasion show, how is this going to work? But then I also thought to my mind, wait, the Secret Invasion storyline is an Avengers storyline, not a normal storyline with starring Nick Fury and Maria Hill. What are you doing here? And if you look, all the Avengers are dead. From all the teasers and the reviews, everybody's been saying it was like gonna be an espionage thriller, basically like Winter Soldier, and who do you trust, and kind of mix, and instead of changing with the Avengers, they're making it a little bit more street level, more personal, and making it more human, with the human characters, not really a superhero show. So that sounded kind of interesting to me. That sounded intriguing. Something different for the MCU, but using a familiar template, but expanding on what you can do with that sort of tone. So we got the first episode, and let's talk about what were my thoughts on it. And I thought that this was one of the best first episodes of Marvel ever. I think the first thing is just the tone of it. It's using the tone of Winter Soldier with the spy espionage thriller, and they found a way to use that and expand on it. And I thought they did such a great job with that. And building this sort of this question as to, like, who do you trust? And kind of, as the story progresses, it builds this tension as to, like, so were any of these characters, like, actually themselves? Like, with the opening scene with the first 5 minutes with Ross, and you bring in Talos and Maria Hill and all that, I'm like, wait. You realize Ross was a Skrull in this scene, you're like, wait. Was Ross a Skrull in the Black Panther films? And this guy was receiving all this information? I'm like, this can't be, right? This has to be impossible. And so then, and I'm like, it questions, like, do these characters, like, who do you trust? And then it even questions when you see the scene with Rhodey and the president. Is Rhodey actually, like, a Skrull, or is he actually Rhodey? Sharon Carter, is she actually a Skrull? Is that why she wants to get into government secrets and all that? It questions you. But besides all that cool stuff, I think it also, even when you get to the end of the episode, when you get the death of Maria Hill, obviously she's not one of the most terrible characters of all time, but it uses that template of who do you trust? And you thought that it was Nick Fury, and it wasn't. And she dies. At least we don't know if she's really dead, because Marvel tends to fake deaths a lot. But if they're faking that these characters aren't actually dead, they got killed, who knows if Maria Hill's actually dead, but it leaves on that cliffhanger, like, wow, that's pretty crazy. But even on a character level with, you know, Talos, honestly, there was a lot of stuff that was actually revealed to me that I actually didn't know about this. Like, Talos, Like, and it had this cool idea of, like, Talos getting kicked out of the Skrull Council, and there was this new guy that got brought up, and he's leading the Skrull Council now, and they're basically infiltrating the planet with government secrets and planning this war between the United States and Russia. But then there's this also interesting plotline that was in Captain Marvel. First, two things. One, the whole plotline about Captain Marvel and Nick Fury finding a planet for the Skrulls did not happen, so since Talos got kicked out, Graphic is coming in here, and since they can't find a home, they have a place there, and they are now taking over, they're infiltrating the planet as they go. That's an interesting plotline. But then the Gaia storyline, I didn't know anything about that. Like, I like Captain Marvel, I like the Captain Marvel film, but I actually forgot that film took place in the 90s. And I remember Gaia's, that means that little Skrull girl, she's a lot older now. So that's why Emilia Clarke is playing her. She's the older daughter, the little Skrull girl in Captain Marvel. That's her. I'm like, I was so shocked by that. But I thought Emilia Clarke's character did something really well, as this kind of reminded me of the character from Falcon and Winter Soldier, Carly Morgenthau, where she was like leading this camp of refugees of Skrulls who didn't have a home, so she's leading them, and she's working for the other people with this guy Gravik, which I thought was a nice introduction. He doesn't have enough time to do anything yet, but he was interesting to see. And then of course, you know, you guys talk about Nick Fury, just the tease as to what is coming for this character to learn about him, that he's not wearing his eye patch, he's not exactly what he used to be. I think the last thing we're going to, and I'm really interested to see where his character goes in the show. And then I think the last thing we're going to talk about here is Olivia Colman's performance. It brings the levity as to how serious this show is. She's kind of a fun mix to add in it. Just a little bit of funness. So I thought that was kind of fun. Now let's kind of talk about some of the issues I have with this show. And I think probably my biggest issue with this episode is that it's an episode, as the first episode of this series with five more episodes, it's a series that doesn't really have a lot of questions answered. And what I mean by that is that you don't really know why Nick Fury is different after the blip. You don't really know why Talos is acting a certain way. We don't really know why. There's a lot of questions here that we don't really know answered, because we have five more episodes coming. And I guess you could say it's an issue we don't know stuff, but that's only because we're getting closer to what's coming for the good. Now, granted, the results to these answers, to these questions, could be either good or bad, but whatever comes out, I'm interested to see where these resolutions come to, and I can talk about it. Overall, I thought this was a great introduction to this show. I am super excited for next week's episode. Just felt like a brush of breath there. Oh, and I forgot to mention the whole intro of the AI. I actually thought it was a really cool way to do it. Like, who do you trust? And what is real, what's not. It was a cool way to do an intro. I don't understand why people are hating on it. I guess it's because it's not CGI. It's not practical effects. People just did art. They're using AI for it. I don't care about that. I just like something unique and different. And that's what that is. So overall, I really liked this first episode. Before I give my final score, be sure to comment below. What were your thoughts on the first episode of Secret Invasion? Did you guys love it? Did you guys hate? Where in between? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. With that said, let's get all my scores. Alright, so that's it for my scores. But before we get in this video, we have to talk about my thoughts on Phase 5 and if I'm excited for these next 5 episodes. Well, I think Phase 5, as of right now, with 2 films and 1 episode of a show coming out, I think this phase is getting a bit better. It started out terribly with Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania. I can't even think about that movie because it's like, There's just nothing I really liked in the movie besides the introduction of the Quantum Realm, which we'll probably never see again, King the Conqueror. Good performance, but he got defeated by ants, and people that can turn small. Come on. But then you get Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, and that was surprisingly one of the best films in the MCU. I was not expecting that to be better than No Way Home. To be as good as Endgame. I did not expect that to be as good as Endgame. It's not better than Endgame, but it's as good. It's almost as good. That's crazy to me. And then we get this. And with Guardians 3 coming out last month, I'm like, I have hope. I have hope now. Maybe Marvel can be back, can be good again. Let's hope. And even with the upcoming Marvel shows and movies that are coming out in the next couple months, I'm starting to get a little excited. And even with Across the Spider-Verse that came out this past week, this past month, I'm getting a little excited. Let's hope. Now that we have the first episode, I can definitely say I am very excited for the next 5 episodes, and I will be staying interested. I really hope this is not a flop like last year, because I thought last year just did not have any good shows. I mean, Moon Knight was good, sort of, but it just did not click for me. Miss Marvel was just terrible. I could not even stand. I can't even really watch it because of how bad the CGI is. And even when it came to the action, it's like, most of it was just not that great. A performance can't sell me on a show that being bad. And then, She-Hulk was fun, but there wasn't really a story there. It was just more of a show of references. That's all it was. Besides that, I'm very excited for Secret Invasion. Cannot wait. And that's my review for it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. All my social media stuff is in the About section over there. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.